All right, here comes a real beauty. You got a G, and then a D11. But really, what I'm doing there is just kind of cheating and barring the top three strings at the fifth fret and letting the D go underneath them. And that's probably the nicest solution if you're just gonna play the song. But you could also just bar the top five strings. Ooh, maybe that's the nicest way to do it. Anyway, you got four repeats of this intro. So that's a G for two strums, an F sharp minor for two strums, and an E minor for four. Now the thing that is funny in this song is not everybody sounds like they're playing the same chord at the same time. Like, I think I hear some people playing the string, a D with the F sharp bass. And the interesting thing is, when you listen to the harmony vocal by Chris Hillman, he's dark and love. See that? Da, that harmonizes with that chord. But if you play the F sharp, you hear da, a C natural against a C sharp. Like the chord has a C. Da, the string. Maybe they're doing that on purpose. But that's a bit of a crunch. The string. Yeah, I shouldn't assume they're just disagreeing. But it is one of the interesting things about this song. There's, some people seem like they've got the F sharp, some people have got the D. So it depends on what you want to do. If you want to just sing the song at the campfire, just do the freaking D. And you don't even need the F sharp, you can just dark end of the street. Then it goes again. It's where we always meet. But if you want to play with the Burrito Brothers, you can do the other street. That's where we always meet. And yeah, that's In the notes, I'm gonna put F sharp the first time and D the second time. That way you can see both options and whatever. Anyway, that's the first two lines. Then you got the third line is hiding in shadows where we don't belong. So just two beats of G, two beats of C, four beats of G. And then the fourth line, you got living in darkness to hide our wrongs. Okay. Then you get in this beautiful chorus. You and me at the dark end of the street. So it's all C to G, C, D, G, C to G to D. And that's the main structure of the song. And, you know, it's interesting, the solo is, or there's actually there's a bridge too that brings in an E minor. They're gonna find us. Gonna find us someday, steal away. Then right into a chorus. At the dark end of the street, you and me. And then it's interesting, like when you get to this solo, it's really clearly F sharp minor. You know, like the pedal steel melody is playing the C sharp. So it's just an interesting, they call that a cross relation. In classical music, it's a cross relation when someone's singing a C over a C sharp. Dark end of the street. And maybe they're doing it on purpose. It definitely adds a, just like a little sweet and sour sauce into the flavor equation. Okay, so, oh, here's another thing too. The recording is a little bit, I think, a little sharp. So I wanted to talk about, if you come across that, just how to tune your guitar. Like, you just let the recording go, and then I'm gonna start by tweaking the G. Yeah, see? Hear that? Okay, now that I so you just gotta slightly tighten these up a little bit, but don't feel like you gotta do that either. Just yeah, now my guitar sounds out of tune, like a Burrito Brothers record. It's interesting, there is a piano on here, so it could be like the piano they're using is not in perfect tune, so everybody just kind of went a little sharp. Anyway, get your G's ready, and we're going to strum through. It's beautiful. I love this. Bridge comes that E minor. So I go with the F sharp here, I guess. Sneaky Pete.
Oh, darling, please don't cry.
Okay. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention strumming. You can see it's very casual, but as it goes along, you can do like. Whoa, now we're in burrito tuning. You start doing down, 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 down. But generally, you could just do a down. Especially when you get in those verses, it could just be all downs, like dark in love. Oh, I did a little up in there. Down, and I notice like there should be a D there, and sometimes not everybody's hitting that. I think it's a good era in music where, not everybody has to kind of be always playing the same chords. And but I would say it's mostly the F sharp, and then, but personally, if it was like a campfire or whatever, just do the D. It's gonna go smoother, I think. But yeah, so beautiful. Graham Parsons killing it on that lead vocal too. There's real. I think it's funny, like some of the burrito stuff, I find him. There's a layer of irony in there, and but I feel like this is he's going from the heart here, so. That beautiful. Okay, enjoy.